both my husband and I liked communications and we liked words. He was a reporter, and it seemed like a good idea to go out and find our own newspaper.
It certainly has been interesting for our community, the fact that the Ballantines chose to move to Durango from the east, or I guess they think of it as the Midwest. The Ballantines came to Durango, it was before the gas boom in the San Juan Basin. It was before Purgatory, it was before Fort Lewis was moved into town. So it was a pretty sleepy little town at that time that just served the extractive industries of agriculture and mining and timber.
Well, then of course streets weren't paved, and we loved it, and so did the children, because the sheep came through in the spring and fall, going to or from winter pasture, and it was fun to hear them in town.
The newspaper adds a real fabric to a community that, you know, getting your news off of CNN, there's no local fabric in that.
Well, she's always made it clear that the newspaper has to make a profit. It has to be a viable business undertaking, but she also believes very strongly in good news and opinion and editorial coverage. And so we have, as a result, a newsroom that's larger than a typical newsroom for a paper this size. And I think our readers appreciate that. They like local stories, local coverage.
The perspective that Morley and Arthur brought from a more cosmopolitan world was useful, was beneficial, was helpful to the community as we grew, because they had seen things that many of the rest of us had not seen. They could bring, they had contacts, they had education, they had some things that we didn't have, and yet, you know, we had some things that they didn't have.
Intelligent, generous, modest, extraordinarily charitable, humble but proud, a quiet leader, a mentor to hundreds, a good listener, a woman of dignity, always informed, but always aware of the ambiguity underlying most critical issues, always willing to support the arts and education, both regionally and nationally, open-minded but strong-willed ad infinitum. So much of what you want to say about Morley, the laudatory phrases sound cliched, but for that woman, they were extraordinarily true and accurate.
Education really is the, whether it be at the job at hand, like reading and writing, or whether it's having a life that you enjoy, is really the basis of our lives.